Okay.
This conference will now be recorded.
Okay.
Okay, so just put the date on the left side, please.
Yeah, I will put.
And so when you have raw material, then we create the vendor. So.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. So in my previous class, we are discussing the process industries. Okay. In that, we created the two master data, material master and POM. Okay. And work center also we created that day.
Yes.
Correct. So now work center, while creating, it did not saved actually. Okay. Because of controlling area. Okay. Now, once again, I will create production process. You are able to see my screen?
Yes.
Nicholas, you are also able to see my screen?
Yeah, but I am muted. Yeah. Can you hear
Nicholas,
me?
Yes,
Nicholas has very good internet connection, and Nicholas has four eyes, you know, he can see it.
Oh, okay. Okay, so
he has a glasses, so he can see it.
Oh, okay. So once again, I'm creating the resource. So that day did not saved actually. Let me see.
Unit.
So I'm saving it without entering casting data. So I saved it first and change mode. I'm going to casting to find any cost centers are there or not. 001. Okay. No cost centers in this control area. Okay. So no cost center. Okay. Without casting, we will we'll go ahead. Okay. So I created the resource. Okay. Today I will clean that data and everything. We'll see. Okay. Now work center RES1 is created. Now we will go into the master recipe. So till now, for master material, master BOM and work center, there is no difference. There is no much difference between discrete or process. The main difference is this master recipe. Okay, main difference. We will go. Theoretically, both are same, but we will see the different screens here. So what are those? We will see, discuss now. And this is the master recipe path and recipe and master list. This is the transaction code C201. C201 is the transaction code. Open this. So first you can enter our material code and then enter the plant and then enter profile. Here is the profile is a mandatory. Profile is nothing but a PI01. You can use this is a standard profile PI01. You need to enter these three details: material, plant, and profile. Then press enter. So you will find a different screen here. Okay. So the different screen means in routing you will have a top tabs to go to operations header details, but here everything is in a here tabs. In routing you will find a buttons here, but here is everything is in a tabs.
Okay. Now is recipe one, it come from the system or?
Yeah, it will come from automatically from system. It is like group number.
Mm-hmm.
Group counter.
And the recipe group, when we save it, then the recipe group will come.
Correct. When we save it, recipe group automatically it will come.
I see. So in this data, when we create the master, I mean, what you call resources, then the system will give us a two thing. One is recipe group and recipe.
Yes,
I see.
Recipe group and counter. Counter is nothing but a one. Okay. So in recipe header, these two are mandatory, like status and uses. Status, you can expand and you can see really generally the status. And uses, uses we are using this for the production. You can select production.
In status, can we use other option like release the order or no?
Yeah, you can use release it for order. If you select this one, mm-hmm. it is only useful. This recipe is only for order
this
only.
This order.
Yeah, not this order, but for this material, any kind of production orders. If you
and
put only release, but it is not good for costing. It is not released for costing.
And
if we select released only for costing,
mm-hmm.
okay, so it is only for costing, it is not for order creation.
Mm-hmm.
Created means if you put the created, when you create the order, this recipe will not be used. It will say it is still in the created status, you need to release it.
Mm-hmm. And
if
what
this
about
recipe is in, yeah.
General, what about the general?
General means it is released for all. For order and costing, it is released.
I see. So general means whatever you have in the complete recipe,
yeah,
it will be released.
Correct. Wherever you are using this recipe,
mm-hmm.
it can be used for that.
I see. Okay.
So that is the reason we will put always generally,
okay.
release it general. Okay. So this tab, like in routing header tab,
mm-hmm.
then in routing we will enter the operation details. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Here also you can click on the operations tab here. Okay. Here in this operation tab, we will enter the operations. 10, 20, 30, 40 like this. Okay. And we will enter the resource means routing. Resource means the work center you will enter, and you will enter the standard values. Okay. Then what is the difference? Difference is in recipe, we need to enter the two operations. It is a mandatory.
Two operations.
Will enter in two operations.
I see.
Yeah, two operations is a mandatory. In routing you can enter only single operation also. Here,
okay, where is the other operation?
I will tell you. Okay, first operation, first is called the operation.
Mm-hmm.
Second is called the sub operation. This is called phase. In recipe it is called the phase. It is nothing but a sub operation. What its meaning is, for example, operation is, okay, beer. Beer means you can say, what are the other words? Fermentation. Okay, that is the operation. Fermentation is the operation. So in this fermentation, they will do some sub operations. Sub operation means, okay, sub operation means like first fill the barley. Okay, second sub operation like some yeast.
Yeah, leave 24 hours something like.
Yeah, yeast. Third one is like retention time. These are the some sub operations.
I see.
In process industries, they will have the concept like these sub operations. Okay.
And
these are called the phase.
Phase. Okay. All right. I just want to see where the sub operation go in.
I will tell you. That's correct. Okay. Yeah. Now, mission hours. We will put mission hours set up and all these things. Okay. So these mission hours, how much is there? We will keep for phase, not for the main operation. Like to fill the barley, it took 1 hour. To fill the yeast, it took another 1 hour. Retention time, maybe 10 hours. So we will enter the timings at operation level, not at the we will enter it at phase level, not at the operation level. This is the difference. Okay, this is the main difference. Now, is it clear? Any questions on this operation and phase, Nicholas?
Yes, it's clear. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Now I will show you where to how to maintain it. First, for first operation, we will enter the resource. Our resource is RES1, and then press enter. So here you will enter the
permission.
Yeah, fermentation. Okay, and here you can see yet standard values, means like mission hours or setup time. It is non-editable. You cannot edit here against this. Okay, now second one is a sub operation. Okay, that is called this phase. If your second operation is like 20 number is a phase, then what you can do is a second, this you need to put as indicator phase. That is nothing but a sub operation. If you tick mark this, it is nothing but a your sub operation.
And what is the up? It says P. What is the main P?
P means phase.
Phase.
Phase indicator. You can expand and you can see also.
So okay. Can we put the description here on the other side?
Yeah. Now I'm coming. And yeah. Press enter.
I see.
Okay. One more thing is there. Let me put all these details and I will explain this. What is this? Okay. So once you press enter, okay. So in place of this SUP, SUP means superior operation. Okay. So superior operation means this is a phase or sub operation for which main operation. That main operation is nothing but a 0010. That is called the superior operation. That number you need to give. And this field is called a DE, means destination. What is the destination? Destination means, I think when I am explaining the process industries, this process management is there. Okay. You are sending the data to DC systems or PLC system. Okay. You want to send that data to these systems. You need to establish a connection between SAP and this system. That connection is called the destination. That connection is called the destination. So in phase, we will enter what is the destination number. Okay, that means to which PLC or which DCI system you want to send, that details we will enter it here. Okay, so at present you can select any one because we don't have the real now PLC or DCI system. Okay, so what are the options we have here? You can select directly. So what are the details we enter here? We tick mark this face and you can enter this superior operation and a destination. So then this resource automatically will copy from the main operation. Okay, it will automatically copy from main operation. Then here you can enter the details like Phil Barley. Okay, and against this one you can see unit of measure has come automatically for mission and thing labor. Okay, you can fill against these mission hours and this. Is it clear? Any questions?
But you cannot put the hours in
no.
fermentation.
Correct. You cannot put that hours because that is like a heading. Under the heading, you are subdividing. In detail level, you are entering here. So
okay.
The data you need to enter at detail level.
Like so a bill of material.
Yeah.
Yeah. Correct.
So can you put the second item? So second item come in second operation means 10, 20 30. And then
30. Okay. Oh, you want to put operation or sub operation?
No, sub operation.
Sub operation. So 30 also you want as a sub operation. Then you tick mark this one. And this sub operation is for which main operation? Main operation is 10. And this you are sending to the destination 01 and then press enter. Okay. Press enter. Here you can enter the description like retention time.
How come the sub operation is 10 and 10? It should be and it should not be 20.
Because this is the main operation. My main operation is 10. So for sub operation, again sub operation will not be there. It is always your sub operation is for one main operation only. It is not a hierarchy, complete hierarchy, no hierarchy here.
So this first operation they come under sub operation, this both item.
Yes,
I see. Okay,
so these two are sub operations for this main operation.
Okay, so how about if the operation come back again? So there is no way that operation will come again.
1 minute, here I'm entering just like hours here. Okay, now this is example, this is the first operation after fermentation. Okay, yeah. Fermentation is completed. Then again, you want to go to the another operation. Okay, another operation is like filtering. Filtering is your second operation. Okay, so you can enter this. The 40 is nothing but if you not tick mark this checkbox, so that is nothing but your another operation. Okay, and you can enter here filter. Okay, under this main operation, again, you want a sub operation. You can tick mark this one. And this 50 is sub operation for 40. Understood? Now under filtering, you may be first transfer. Transfer material to filter. Okay, transfer. This may be taking 1 hour. So this is the way we need to maintain in recipe.
I see.
Is it clear? Any questions?
No, it's clear. It looks like we are working on some mini bomb and something like this.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the main difference between your routing and recipe.
Routing and recipe. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, this is one part. Now, as I told you, you are sending the data, this data to, or in the last operation, this data to third party system. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What type of information you are sending? Okay. That is called the PI sheet. You can see.
I see.
Okay. Process instruction sheet. Like you are sending the information.
Yeah.
You are telling to the operator, once the last operation is over, you do the confirmation or you do
yeah.
the goods movements.
Yeah, or sometimes any special service, any
correct
external services, for example, is working on transferring or filtering, and
yeah.
that you can send it to him for billing purpose or whatever. I mean, it could be a lot of
correct. Okay, those information you need to assign it to this operation.
So this when you send this information is called PI sheet.
Correct. Inside of this operation, what are the information you are putting now? We are not yet put the details. Okay.
Uh-huh.
So what details you would like to send, that we need to assign it here. That is called PI sheet. Here you select that sub operation and click on this process instructions.
That's Excel sheet.
Yeah.
I see.
One document type. Okay. Click this button.
Okay. In the end, you click it as soon as you finish.
Yeah. If I click it, it will open another screen now. Okay. I'm just
mm-hmm.
clicking it.
Mm-hmm.
Click.
Okay.
I click that icon. You can see this is the process instructions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. SAP have the standard instructions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Standard instruction categories. You can select.
Mm-hmm.
So these many instructions, whichever you want to send, you can send.
Mm-hmm.
For example, goods receipt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Or material consumptions. Okay. That means raw material is there, you are consumed, so that information you are sending, so he will enter how much material he consumed, that information he will send it back. You can select this material consumption details, he will send, press enter. Not only single message, you can send the multiple also. You can enter here. One is material consumption he want to send, and another one is like material GR, how much is the final material they produced it. You can select that. Yeah. Goods movement. So final product, how much is produced? He can send the details. Okay. So like this, you can select multiple details here and he can receive the multiple details. Any quality is there, quality information also you can.
Now, if you send him any details which is not in the PI sheet, means whatever you are looking here, and
mm-hmm.
some other information to correct the product or product add this or there are some any do you is there any log that you can put more information in there?
Yeah, you can create like these categories in the configuration. You
mm-hmm.
can create like you want to send some information like some
So
text you want to
the
enter and you want to send.
so it will be created in the configuration.
Correct.
I see.
Okay, there you can your own, these are SAP defined. If you want to create own, you can put those own details. Okay.
Yes.
So what
Yeah. Can I have an idea
messages?
what is behind of this one? If we create one, for example, just to I'm asking what is behind this?
Okay.
For example, if you are looking to create one, what is this
Correct.
inside?
Okay. So for example, this is there conjunction underscore one. You can select and click on the details button here.
Yes.
Okay. So these parameters it is sending. What is the
Okay,
message
okay.
category? And it will send
Yeah.
you the what is the process order number, which operation, which phase, and which material it is sending, and what is the date and time, and material quantity consumed, how much is quantity consumed. Okay,
Yeah.
and input value. This is a text, and how much is there, it will enter here, and unit of measure. This information it is sending to that third party system against
Great.
this category.
Oh, great.
Okay, and in goods receipt one you want to see, so you can select it, go to the details. You can see it is sending process order, operation phase, material, end date, start date, and this is the how much is produced. Previous one is how much is consumed, this is how much is produced. So he will get the one, just one screen there. He will put the how much quantity is there, only just he will enter the quantity, that's all. Okay, and you can come back. Okay, is it clear how to enter process instructions?
Yeah.
Any questions? Okay, and then you can come back to your normal operations here and you can save it now. Okay,
Yeah.
yeah, I am just saving it. This is the recipe group. If you want, you can see recipe was saved and material. Okay, and now
All this information we will have it from the business, is that right?
yeah, business only they will give. Correct.
Okay, they created or we created?
Okay, that is we need to upload the data. You cannot if they have the 100 materials, 100 one by one creation is very difficult. Okay, so we will upload the data using LSMW or SAP standard upload programs. We will use them and we will upload them. Okay.
Is it something part of the cockpit? For example, for
Yeah,
example,
cockpit.
in MMSD, we use a cockpit to load most of the data. Here, it is part of
Correct.
them for, yeah.
Yeah,
Thank you.
same cockpit on.
Yeah.
Let me.
Can I ask you a question? In your project where you were working, is there PP, S/4HANA PP or any? Whether it's for HANA, did you use a cockpit and it
Yes.
was working very well?
Yeah, we are using
Okay.
cockpit only.
Okay, so we don't use LSMW anymore.
Actually, SAP each release wise they are releasing the new transaction codes in cockpit. Okay,
Okay.
if I am using 1610, so that time they did not release for all the masters that cockpit.
Yeah.
So if that is not there, then I need to use the LSMW only.
Yeah.
But in
Right.
1809 they have released the more master data. Okay. Using cockpit.
Is the cockpit is also SAP application?
Yeah, SAP only.
And this is
like
same like LSMW transfer the data?
Yeah, it is a kind of, but the standard templates will be there. Just you, for example, you want to load BOM, just download the template, standard template from the cockpit, fill the data and upload. That's all. You don't require any recording, or you don't require to put any formulas. Nothing is required.
Yeah, but in LFCW is this, that which data you want to upload and which data you don't want to upload. That's an option in LFCW has.
LSMW also you will record. Only difference is first you need to record, then you will make the one text file and you will upload.
Right.
Okay, as per your recording. But in cockpit, SAP will give the template. You need to fill the mandatory data and you will upload. You know, you don't require to record actually. That is the main difference.
Yeah. Okay. I see.
Okay. Okay. But I will show you how to that cockpit also. Once this standard course is completed, then I will show you. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Now, after master CP, then what we need to create? Production version. We need to create. Okay. Yeah. Now, in master recipe itself, you can create. Generally, we will use MM02. Okay. If you want, you can use the master recipe itself to create this. Okay. You want to use MM02, you can use it. Otherwise, in master recipe itself, you can use it. Now I will show you how to use that. Go to change mode, not creation mode. Go to change mode, C202. Open our material. You can enter our material. Where? And plant.
This is a CO02, right?
C202.
C202, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Enter beer and plant. Okay. Then here we have one more button, materials. It is opened our operations, whatever we enter. And here now click on the materials. You can see production version screen is opening. When you click materials button, it has opened your production version screen. Did you remember this screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So here you enter any production version number, PV01, and beer for beer of German. And here master recipe number automatically came. That is the advantage.
I see.
Okay, because inside of the recipe we are entering, so group is automatically came. If you want to use MM02, this group you need to select and enter. Okay. Now BOM we already created, so you can select that BOM. And
usage
and check button. So list is there and BOM exists. And you can see both are green and click OK. So it is simple. Okay. So in materials tab, when you click first time, it will come that production version details screen. So there you enter the details. Okay. And in the materials tab, you can see the production version number and BOM details. BOM means we put the barley. Yes, BOM. So right. You can see the details here. Okay, and here once again you want to see that production version screen, then you need to click this button. If you click this button, so that screen will come.
Oh, the same. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I see.
Can close. Once you enter the production version details.
So, ask a question. Product version is always one, or we can have a product version 2, 3, 4 later.
Yeah, I will tell you now. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Is it clear? Awesome. Creation of production
yeah,
version.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Correct. Yes.
Now, this is from the CO02, right?
C202.
C202. Let me write it down. C202. So, but same thing we can create from the MM02, right?
Yes, you can create from MM02 also.
So MM02 as normally we did it previous.
Correct.
Application.
Correct.
Okay.
Okay, I'm saving it now.
Mm-hmm.
Saved. Okay. Now, is it clear? Creation of master recipe and production version. Okay. With this,
yes,
your
okay.
master data
could we,
creation.
Could you mention the master recipe PI03, for example, automatic code receipt, or we can have this possibility?
Yes. We can change it. Okay. I am now opening our master recipe once again. Mm-hmm. And you can see in the last operation, mm-hmm. I am putting PI03. So auto GR will happen. Okay. Here is the control.
Is there any backflash? We can do backflash in the processing or not?
Backflash, that is in the metal master directly. You can save this. Clicking on save.
Sorry.
And in material master of component, your component is Barley. I'm opening Barley now. Okay, so here in MRP2, I think it is already there because we copied it. Oh no, it is not there. So you can select.
We could put the backslash bomb, or we can do it for the beer or no?
No, for beer it is not required. Backslash is for components.
Only for component, keep it open. Okay. Because
it's just auto force issue.
Yeah, I know for this issue, but I'm not sure if you say it's okay. Can we mention it? In the bomb, and in this case, it will issue the component, or no, this one is not working. So I was looking to ask you if you can see the backslash in the component, the bomb. And in this case, as soon as we put it in the bomb, so it will be reflected in the component, or not necessary.
No, we need to maintain only for the components only.
Okay.
So in the BOM, automatically it will consider in the back end.
So the backflash we cannot use in a process production.
Yeah, you can use it. That is the reason I put no for Barley.
So what is the main reason for the backflash?
Backflash is auto goods issue, auto consumption.
Auto goods issue. Okay. Auto goods
issue. In confirmation screen, automatically this material will come with 261 movement type.
I see. Okay, so backflash for a component. So it means we can use the backflash for every product then?
Yeah, you can use it.
Yes.
Any components.
Any components, any product. If discrete or process, repetitive, any process.
Correct. Okay. Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. I am saving this. Now, I am coming to your point, Nicholas. So you ask me, can we create the production version 2, 3 like that? Okay. When we will create that production version, multiple production versions. Till now, we are using the single production version only. So when you will use multiple production version is like, example, you are making beer, okay? You can make this beer using barley, or you can use using the rice, correct?
Yes.
Correct. So
yeah.
If your component is barley, then this is example like BOM1. And if you are using rice as a component, this is a BOM2.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, yeah.
In this case, you need, in a same production version, you cannot maintain two BOMs. In same production version, you cannot maintain two BOMs. Okay. Then in this case, you will create a production version PV01 with BOM1 and routing 1. Your machine is same routing 1. You will create another production version BOM2 and routing 2, routing 1. Okay.
Okay.
In this case, wherever you have the multiple BOMs, so in that case you can create a multiple production versions.
Oh, great.
Okay.
And we can create, use this one or this one by date, is that right?
Correct. In production order, you can select. You will select, okay, today I am using the rice, so I will select the production version 2. Tomorrow I am using with the barley, so that order you will select with production version 1.
So is there any, for example, BOM3, then you can use the BOM3, then you can use the product version PV03?
Yes, you have a BOM3. Uh-huh. Okay, PV03 you will create.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in this case, you require to create a multiple production versions. Okay. So now.
Great. Thanks, Vasu.
Yeah. Thank you. Welcome. So now, the required master data is completed. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
For PP, what are the master data is required? It is completed. Okay. Now we will go to run the process. Like first we will create forecast. Okay. We will execute all these steps now.
Okay.
It can be make to order. No. So, sorry. Can we mix between a process and make to order?
Yeah. The only difference is if it is make to order, you will create an order. That's all.
Yeah.
OM61 create the forecast.
Forecast is correct. This is
MD61.
The only difference for make to stock or make to order is only sales order. You can create a sales order and proceed remaining step.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we will go to the MD61 and we will see now.
Yeah.
Okay. You can see you have the same transaction in the process industries also. Production process, open the production planning, demand planning, and then independent requirements, MD61. Open. Enter your material beer, and then plant. Okay. And the same horizon, monthly, and press enter. So here you can enter values.
About 10 gallon
something. Yeah.
50 gallon. Okay.
Yeah. 10, 20, 10 I put. Okay. 10 gallon, 20 gallon, 10 gallon. And save it. This is normal. There is no difference.
No difference. Yeah.
Okay. So then we can check this in MD04. So for this you can expand MD04 environment. You can see stock requirement list. Enter beer and plant and press enter. Okay. So whatever you enter the independent requirements, it is showing.
Right.
Okay. Now the second step is MRP run. You can use same MD01N.
MD01N, yes.
Yeah, okay. So open this MD01N. Same, enter plant, material, and all components.
Yes.
Scheduling.
Yes. Scheduling.
Lead time scheduling. And this is planning mode 1.
1 and execute.
Execute, correct. Materials. Okay, then I'm coming out, and now if you go and see MD04, planned order should be created. You can see
which order, which transaction you use it.
See MD04.
I see. Okay,
yeah, wheel is the same.
Yeah, yeah.
Stock requirements list.
Yes, yes. I thought maybe a different query. Okay, no. Now independent. One question I have here, now this plan order you have, and this is the independent requirement. Now plan order is convert to production order. When you click here, I want to see which window is coming, because can you click this one?
Okay. So I'm going to the next step only. That is the next step. Okay.
Yes.
So you have the three independent requirements, and your system created the three planned orders. Okay.
Yeah.
So after MRP run, so you saw the where is the planned orders, that is in MD04. Now next step is convert
to process order.
Process order. Okay. Uh-huh. How to convert this?
I see.
You can use same MD04 transaction code. Okay, or you can use a different transaction codes, like individual CO40 is there that time. Here you will have a different transaction codes. Okay, I will show you that also. Okay, so how to convert this in MD04? You click this button. Same window will come,
right?
Like discrete only. Now here you need two buttons. Here you can see planned order to production order, but this is not a production order, this is a process order. So here is the button
production.
Convert planned order to process order,
PROC.
Oh, process order. I see. Okay, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So we are not doing the production, but we are doing process order. Okay, okay,
correct. But the same window is same only, but you need to select different button. Okay, you need to click on
but this. Sometimes when you work and by mistake when you do you have any alternate code for that?
No, actually it should show an error if I click production order. Okay, it is asking, you can see order type.
I see.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay,
you need to enter the PA01, not the PP01. Okay, if you enter the PA01 system, what it is saying? Not defined,
yeah,
because this is not a production order, it is a process order. Okay, so then you need to come back and now you select it and click on process order.
Okay,
click this. So once you click this one, you can see the difference.
Yeah.
Okay. Automatically it will come into this screen actually. So some issue is with the some configuration, some those people they're disturbed. Okay. That is the reason it is going to a settlement rule. Okay. I will check why this settlement rule is not coming automatically. Okay.
Do we need the settlement rule in this process order?
Yeah, it will come actually automatically. Okay. Because somebody has changed this one. Distribution format only be created automatically. Distribution rule. Okay. So that is the reason it is not coming. Okay. So category.
I think the enterprise structure is is very complicated things. That's why it's come. When we work, there are a lot of errors will come now.
Correct, correct. So let me try MAT. So actually, this is the
I'm trying to do. I think I'm gonna work as infrastructure from beginning and work.
Yeah. Okay. So actually, without entering anything, without that the settlement screen is there. Without entering anything, I press enter. It came to you can see create process order screen. Okay, create process order screen.
And now
I will come back once again. I am not saving anything. Okay, I did not save anything. Now once again I am going back. Planned order. Click process. On process order, and then just press enter, or you can click on back button.
And then a green flag.
Yeah.
Release.
Okay. So here. This is like a production order, all details will be there. You don't find any big difference here. Okay.
So we general can data, all this. We can release the order and save it.
Correct. You want to do the release also here, you can do it. Release
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Okay. You can see release rejected. Some errors are there. Okay.
Oh, rejected.
You can save it.
Okay, in this situation you save it if it's rejected.
Yeah, it will save but it won't release actually. You need to correct those issues.
I see.
Okay. Production order.
I think you can you cannot do the other jobs, and let me create this enterprise structure tonight and then
okay. No. Don't create now. First you practice this process industries. Otherwise, you'll forget it. Okay.
This process we can do it, but this process how it work because the
that I will check it today. That I will check it today. Okay. I will check it, but you practice it.
Yes. Okay.
So I will stop the class now. I think Nicholas has to go to another class.
Yeah, Nicholas is in English.
Today I don't have a class. To tell you the truth, I don't have a class today. But
why you didn't say I wanna go.
Okay, okay.
But I will go.
okay. So I will stop the class here. Is it clear till now?
Yes.
So yeah. Absolutely clear. Yeah. Thanks.
Yes.
We need to release and we need to do the remaining steps.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So I will stop the class now. Okay.
Yes.
We'll continue the remaining class tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow. Yeah. Tomorrow is a Sunday.
Yeah. I took the 2 days break. No. Can we continue tomorrow also? Or you have any work?
We can continue. I don't have any. We can continue.
Nicholas, do you have anything? Or maybe you have any date on Sunday?
No, morning. Yes, not the night time. I'm home at night. Okay, we can do class tomorrow. One, two.
Okay.
All right.
If Jamal agrees to, if Jamal and Wasu agree, we can do class.
Yeah.
Okay.
For me, no issues. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
Okay,
you.
Nicholas. Okay. Okay,
Thank
Doas, Mr. Vasu. Thank you.
Okay.
Have
tomorrow
good day.
we'll
yeah.
We'll continue tomorrow class same time. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Bye.
Hey, Vasu.